the A bomb site, and it's going to be patient information gathering from Pete. You can see he starts to back up, throws a pop flashball, which will land on Relix's face. We'll have to take a moment behind the pillar. And, but if Pete goes down, we could see a quick push here from the T side.
Nice flash. So they're really raising the level of threat towards B at the moment, as Savage are trying to pull players towards that site. As it's like right now, they are holding pretty steady, just keeping Pete on that B bomb site at the moment, and they are reacting very, very well, reading the map perfectly. As Savage do make their way in slowly. And Slip going to make a kill to do more. They're on the defense here. Zek does work that P2000 there down from the pit. And it's actually going to be a very labored approach here for Savage. Really struggling to get themselves in on top of that bomb site. And now it's just on the Valance, who certainly is going to have a very tough time here against the three opponents. Still left alive for mobility in this pistol round. He's going to back away towards B. He does actually have the time to go for this. And if he does, it's like snap the neck of Pete straight away in this one-on-one, then that's going to be significant. We should be able to get the bomb down, but it depends on how Pete is able to play the delay game. But it doesn't even matter. Going to just pop his head, and we have the round there for mobility.
So that is going to be an important pistol round for the CT side. This is a CT-heavy map, but you do need the economy in order to get those frags. We're going to see the potato gun coming out here for Pete. So we'll see where he chooses to take it. And we've got the rest of his team going for the main primary rifles. We've got three FAMASs and an M4 for the CT side. We do have P250s for four of the five T players, and Hades is going to only get the flashbang. Otherwise, it's a full eco for him. So fairly certain at this point that he is going to be looking for that AWP as soon as possible.
Pete deciding to venture down there as a teammate does smoke deep banana. I love this there from mobility, but the push is going to come in from Savage with those pistols. And looks like, you know, so far so good here for mobility. Easy cleanup of the anti-eco. And there you go. Nobody lost. Barely anybody even scratched there. So things looking good for mobility. And Savage, having not found an opportunity to actually plant a bomb, else still needing to eco. It's actually quite a lot of cash on their side. They should invest here for sure into something, whether it's just a couple of pistols and some grenades. We're going to see that as well, as they are starting to do that. And Savage, what are they going to look towards here for their options? It looks like mobility very comfortable playing aggressively on banana with that those smoke angles towards those deep, for those deep smokes, which is great to see.
Okay, so it's going to be a slower push here from Savage. They are going to go for safety in numbers and try and bring the pain towards the A bomb site here. Going to smoke off quad and go for the expected one man on arch. Zek is going to get the information and try and back off. 5 HP, got to save his FAMAS, make sure the T-zone gets to it. Relix is going to try and hunt him down, but the spray isn't going to get any connections, and Glorians will take down Zek and pick up the FAMAS for his team, but the grenade from Pete will take him out. We have Sidov just stopping the wraparound here, and the T's are going to be stuck in the CT spawn for the time being.
Much better damage done this time around, and here comes Sidov turning the corner, going to take down Glorians, as we do have Valens left over by Library, as he is going to make his way now onto that bomb plant. So finally, it's going to be Savage able to get that bomb planted at the very least. Also a 1-on-2, so a doable situation here for Valens, but he will go down to Lucky. But again, three men taken down that round, the bomb planted. Certainly a very nice result for Savage, and after the last couple of rounds, something they desperately needed.
Yeah, that was a very nice flash off the wall from Lucky to as he approached the site post-plant, so I'll definitely be stealing that one for FACEIT Pugs. And we have Zek pulling out the AWP, and Hades actually not going for the AK after all. Not sure if he was slightly short of money, but it's going to be AKs all round for the Savage team. And they've all gone for one nade, two flashbangs, and one smoke, which is very concise.
Yeah, and here we go. Zek going to actually maybe find an angle, but actually he stops just before he does get onto that potential shot there. But it could still be possible here, as Zek is contesting Banana heavily with his AWP. Has support there from Sidoff directly behind him, but it looks like that position is compromised. Going to fall back so as not to lose any lives. We do have the boost there on Slip above quad. This is a nice one. We've seen Fifth Lauren of NIP using this very often recently in the matches we have seen of Nips Inferno. To great effect, I might add.
Oh, I think Hades might have seen a leg there. He's looking for the second man where there normally is in a situation when someone is boosted. Yeah, we push it through. I was just assuming the first time, but he does get the frag, and we'll get the second one as well, which is going to open the A bombsite wide. Can he hold here with his AWP?
Does get smoked off. There's a tiny gap to lip through, but looks like KD's going to take him down. So, not to be desired here for mobility, as Pete is going to sweep on by that AWP and just, you know, well, sweep it off to safety. As Sidoff also is going to get an upgrade and you know, move to safety as well. So far, Savage. I mean, it was all down to Hades, really. You know, that double kill on the entry there towards quad, just snuffing out the boost straight away. That was really unlucky for mobility to kind of get caught off, like, in that timing. And that was more or less the round for Savage. Upon that, they were able to react so quickly off the back of those two kills to get onto the site. And mobility certainly going to be having some problems now with Savage as the economy starts to really get going.
Yeah, normally it takes a hell of a lot longer to push quad because you normally have to deal with a crossfire setup. Sometimes there's a guy site, sometimes there's a guy apps, sometimes it's pit and site, etc., etc. But Hades gets two 1v1s there as somebody was hiding behind the wall just in case somebody threw the flash up mid, then he can go for the repeat. But in that situation, Hades just came out guns blazing, took both the plays down, and will be a significant help to getting Savage their first round on the board here.
And is it JW? No, wait, it's Zek. Does take down Glorens there with an aggressive apartments push. Lovely stuff there, working those aggressions. Then we're going to see Lucky take down Hades towards middle as well, as Slip is just testing the waters before backing away. They've done the damage. Already two players picked off with aggressive movements. And Savage now have to scrap together a play with the three remaining souls. Valens, Relics, and Dumor. Looks like they are going to try to respond by pushing Banana. Certainly it's going to take some great entry fragging here to make this round possible. We'll have to see what they have in store as they are lining up the smokes. And they go to the site. Savage have to contest with these great pop flashes, and it's Pete to take two quick frags there as Dumor is the last man standing, and he can see nothing. It is stuck behind the smoke, back to the wall. Gonna run along the side and get taken out promptly there by Pete, who does manage to score the triple on the defense there of the B site. So far, so good. Mobility looking great on that 4-1 scoreline, and Savage hopefully not going to get exploited too much by those aggressive plays.
Great counter flashes there by Sidoff on the B bomb site. So helping his teammates go for the peaks while he's flashing all the T's. They can't face the site because of that flash, so that's a really important one. Some people do it slightly angled, so it falls towards Paul. But we are into the next round here, and Pete will get the early pick here. Glorens following some grenades. However, his teammate does go down, and Mobility lose two players in quick succession. Pete banking on the A push, but in fact, the bomb is going to be on B. The T side can probably hear him running through Speedway, and that will give them an indication that there's at least one less person, but they're going to wait for that smoke to dissipate just in case they're being baited by that running. And they're going to have Relics just hanging around here, looking for some frags, maybe some rotation kills. Seems they're still a bit uncertain about what the situation is here on the B bomb site, but there haven't been any nades here for a while, no smokes, no flashes from the CT side, so there has to be alarm bells in their head. But the CT side, they've made a quick commitment here, and it may not pay off. We've got Relics running distraction now, but Zek is in a position to try and hold the site here.
And look at that. Zek immediately, upon seeing Relics actually make contact, rotated, and he lost the angle before the smoke went down. He actually lost the angle there with the AWP. That's actually quite huge for Savage. So big play there to delay that rotation and confuse mobility. And Savage in with a very solid chance there. They got the bomb down. In comes Zek there with the AWP. Going to miss the first shot as he does line up for another one. And Savage in some decent afterplant positions, though. Smoke to the back of the site, and that's going to allow Pete for a 1-on-1. Here it is. Does take down Dumor. In goes the spray there towards Hades' position. They can't quite find him just yet, but they know he's there. They know he's there somewhere behind that smoke. He's getting gunned down. Can't see a single thing. And it will be a good retake there from Ability. And Savage unable to make that work. And I can't help but wonder how that would have gone for them had they been more aggressive initially on construction. And
yes.
So they're waiting in the back of the site.
I think they just took too long to actually push the site as well. They were looking for some play. But then it's not in every day where you see two people on the B bomb site. One goes down, you're aware the other guy's there, and he knows. You both know that you're aware that he is there. and he instantly rotates to A. I haven't seen that before, so you can't blame Savage too much for holding the angle there and waiting for something to happen. But they did get their bomb down, which will allow them to get a mixed buy in here. We've got Valens, no rifle on him, but we're going to have two Galils and two AKs here for the rest of the Savage team. We have a more aggressive position here by Zek on the B bomb site, and they might move back a little bit. That counter flash there just to stop the push, but Zek is going to hold the angle here. Going to try and get the pick on Relics on top of the logs, but there's going to be no connection just yet. But Slip does find Hades, and another one goes down from Slip on second mid area. So good aggressive play here from the CTs.
Some ability trying to adapt to what they've seen. Now they obviously, after picking up those two frags, they can always just stay passive for the safer plays, the team play setups, the guaranteed setups, or they can take a risk. Looks like they have fallen back now onto a safer position at the back of the site. Lucky gonna find the header balance there. Nice return there from Dumour, though. The response is real. There's also Relics coming in on top of Slip there over towards library side as Relics now makes his way towards that inner bomb site. It's going to be able to have an opportunity to drop the bomb now. And then 1-on-2 is certainly going to be very interesting now as Sidoff and Zek are very nearby. Oh, great shot there from Relics. Here's one more, though. Zek coming there with the AWP, scoping in. The angle does rattle off a shot. Relics now. Going for the spam through the box, trying desperately to find the head, and with the spray, the running gun, he's going to get it. And there you go, another round there for Savage as they go 2-5. And Ability still look very solid on the money, that is for sure.
Relics survived that versus a CZ with more bullets in the chamber with 1 HP. And he is a lucky son of a gun. Savage get their second round on the board here. 2 of 7 rounds. Not bad so far. They are on a less favored T side, let's remember. So, so far, so good. The important thing is that they keep Mobility's economy broken. We can see they have between $0 to $1,200 here. So they're doing a good job of that for the time being. Even with Mobility stringing a few rounds together, they are expensive rounds, which means that Savage have all the opportunities to get back into this game.
So far we're seeing a very standard setup here from Mobility. Very passive on B, passive on A, and awaiting something from Savage. Just playing on the reaction. And so far we see map control taken by Savage up banana. They have two players on apartments and they can pretty much do with the bomb as they want. They're forcing out the grenades from Mobility as early on as they can, and this will definitely keep the option for the double back towards B open if they do decide to go towards A. But it might be Pete creeping through the smoke there. Will find himself a frag onto Hades, and he does escape. Very, very bold move there from Pete, but it pays off as Hades does go down. Lovely stuff there from Ability, I must say, as it looks like Savage are going to go in with the commitment here onto the B-bomb site. In they come, and Pete running with the reload there, and it's going to be Sidoff in the back of the site to try to hold things off here for time being. So his teammates get there, double quickly found as he switches out for the AK, and it might just be number 3, but no, it's close enough though, as we do see Glorious left on 9 health. He does get a quick double, dispatching Zek there at the end, and that puts it to a 2-on-2. In they go, straight through the smoke. They care not of the risk, and it's going to be the cleanup from Savage for round number 3.
Now we're going to see the eco from the CT side here, as they have not much in the bank, varying between 2,200 and 34. So unless they're going to go crazy with some insane force buy, we are going to see a pretty solid eco here from the Mobility team. Again, the economy is tantamount for the CT side here. They still have 2 rounds in the bag. Can expect it to go to 4-5 in favor of Mobility after this round, unless something terrible happens. We've got Slip. This smoke probably came from CT spawn, so that allows him to put 4 people on the A bomb site. Slip has no ammo. Has to be careful here. He could get shot through through the smoke, and then that would be the B bomb site wide open. But we do have all kinds of parties here in the bedroom. Yeah, I think the Mobility team are having a sleepover right now.
Mobility sleepover. That sounds interesting. But,
sounds so enthusiastic. Yeah, that sounds interesting. Yeah, that's great.
Nice pick there from Hades, though. Onto Pete, going to find himself some love at the end of that AK. And this bedroom party is, pretty bad vibes going on right now. People shooting guns outside.
Not much music going on either.
It's not good.
May have a meeting of minds here.
That was worth the silence there, the tension, the anticipation. Gonna see all the kills coming in. Pretty easy stuff there. I like that though. I don't think I've seen a team do that.
Well, it's not
a stacked bunch of people in the bedroom. It's quite cool though.
Indeed, but on these, when the CTs are on eco, the Ts generally avoid the apps area because the biggest advantage for the CTs on an eco is if they have P250s, 5.7s, and they play those close corner ranges in the apps, because from that range, if you shoot someone in the head, even if they have a helmet, they're dead straight away. It's going to be a one-shot death, so you know, bear that in mind when you're on a T side. You want to avoid these close quarters. And we did see that a lot when the Caesar first came up, actually.
Play to your advantages, not your opponent's advantages.
Indeed.
There is the re-smoke for Sidoff, or in fact, maybe the first smoke. So they did lose Pete early on. Savage slowly working through the smoke. Perhaps they can force out one more. Zek does actually have one who is on the B-bomb site as well. So we do have the grenades coming in slowly. Mobility readying themselves for potential aggression, as we see Savage splitting out to make some noise on middle very briefly, as they are going to commit to B.
So Glorians is going to have their back via mid. If any flanks come in, he is probably going to pop someone's head off, and we have Lucky just taking a just retreating towards the pit just in case, but the push is going to come into the B bomb site here, so we are going to see the rotation, and both players from Mobility are going to go down, and this is going to be a safe here for the remaining players, unless this man finds them.
Glorin's on the hunt right now, but he, alas for him, he will not find anybody. And I'm still appreciating the smoothness of the overview now, of the players zooming around the overview from the update. That's got to be the best change. How smooth it is.
Yeah, you have a point. It is quite smooth, actually. At least something works in this update.
Because all the time I make the videos, I always like create the overview capture, and I just capture that. And I'm just looking at it, I'm like, why is it so low FPS? But now it's not anymore. They fixed it. I'm happy.
GG's.
But there's a lot of other things, little bugs for them to fix still.
Yeah, I mean, the recent CSGO patch introduced, unfortunately, a bunch of bugs. So hopefully we won't see any of them today. It is 5-5 now. Savage doing great on the T side here in the first half of this Inferno. Our first match of tonight. Any rounds in addition to this are a bonus. And I do wonder if Mobility will mount a similar offensive when they are on the T side, or how that will run. I mean, we will see. I'm expecting we'll see Hades pick up the AWP on the CT side to match what they've been doing with Zek Mobility. So, still all to play for here.
Certainly is. So, and Lucky, they have left them on the A bomb site. Interestingly, some teams decide with their buy or in a situation like this. Sorry, they did save to actually stick the two on the B bomb site, so that they can either save if the, you know, A is attacked, or have a really strong defense if B is attacked.
Looking at the CT's money, I think they're loosely going to be on the same money even if they all die in this round, and they'll all be able to buy next round. Now, I think in a situation where you've got two players with nades, armor, and M4s, they could go for one of those crazy rushes down the middle of mids, where they try and get some early picks, take off one or two players, because that really does change the round, especially when you have an eco.
Get some weapons on your pistoling players.
Indeed, yeah. But you know, you gets you that early advantage, which does make life a lot easier. But it looks like the T's are gonna push mid here slowly but surely. Again, safety in numbers, and they are going for the biggest advantage, which is on arch, where there's normally one player, as you have apps and pit for the CTs. They did have a boost there on Zek, but the T's were a bit wiser and took him out straight away with no damage to be done.
Slip though with the M4, only to get one though before he does get taken down. And both M4 players are removed very effectively by Savage. He moves 6-5 on the scoreline. And
if you look at the money here from the CTs, you can see again, they're all kind of 5,000 to 6,000. So I think, basically, I mean, you can't do it all the time because then you're predictable. So it may be that the next time that they're in that situation, they do it. But I think you've got to go for the early pick there, try and get an early advantage versus the fully armed opposition.
There's actually another reason why I think that works, but we'll go to another reason or why I think that's actually a very good idea. We're going to see already the frags coming in as the aggression on Banana goes completely just pear-shaped for Mobility, getting dropped immediately towards that site. Lucky alone, oh my god, they've all died within like 20 seconds. But one additional factor is that they knew that the two weapons were alive, and when a team is fully ecoing, your anti-eco strat usually is very, very passive because you expect them to try to do something a bit crazy. When you save weapons, it's not necessarily in the meta that you go very aggressive. It's kind of the opposite usually. Passive play is much, much more common, so teams are less wary of a surprise move. Whereas if it was a full eco, they are super wary of a surprise move. So I did like your point there.
Oh, we have some Horn League action going on here, but Slit is going down, and they're falling like flies on the A bomb site here. I mean, that push from Mobility on Bernardo, I didn't see many nades. I'm sure they were maybe flashes or something, but we've seen the mollies normally to control that area. They weren't there for Mobility, and they find themselves on the eco here. The 1D is not real on this occasion, and Lucky is going to be the last man to prove me wrong here. He is on the A bomb site, and he is not near anybody. Maybe he could pick up Glorin's gun. Not sure where it was dropped, but he's going to go for a walk and admire the Spanish countryside.
And he did get himself the AK after all, so let's see what he can do with it. I mean, if we just do a quick check on the money here, obviously economic damage is not really going to be impactful at all at this stage of the half, and especially considering how much money they have. So just saving the AK is by far the biggest priority for him here. And he's just going to keep a position at pit. It's going to be known that he's there, but that's such a strong position that that's actually quite strong. But the grenade's actually going to certainly make his life a little bit difficult.
Dumour's got 12 HP, but he doesn't care. He's got 9 grand in the bank. Make that 12.
Not quite. Does stay alive.
The tease. That is an AK, which is all important because that can make the difference. One shot to the head and dead. That could bring Mobility back into this game. But again, as we said earlier in this match, the key for Savage will be to break the economy of Mobility. And we have seen they've done that. And look at their buy now. Zek, no kit on him, only $150 in the bank. But this is how you kind of win the lopsided maps like Inferno, at least the T side of them. You know, the same thing could happen when the sides switch over, but Mobility just keep getting picked really fast here. They're not really, I mean, if you looked at the matches of Inferno we saw earlier today, the CT teams were really burning down the clock with Molotovs, with smoke grenades, and we found the T's being forced to push with 30, 25 seconds remaining, but you know, straight away in this round, Savage have a one-man advantage.
And they are making their way up towards A. I think Mobility have a read on this because of Sidoff's very forward position on Banana. I think that he figured it out, and he's already going to move back into the site. We have 3 men to defend this, and they're chucking down the counter grenades. There comes the fire from Slip and Pete on the crossfire. Do get a couple players before Pete does drop. That is a 3-on-3 situation with a rapidly approaching Sidoff there, but Slip going to take down 2 in quick succession, as we do have Glorin's, who is left remaining now, coming from the site. Going to be finding himself 2 players very shortly here, as he does go for the peek. Oh, and the response from Sidoff, a little bit too slow there. Glorin's might just go for the re-peek. The bomb's still down at the feet of Sidoff. Oh, and he looks the wrong way, and Sidoff, it will not miss that shot. And we have ourselves a 6-8 scoreline.
Right now, Zek is 3-10. He's been using that AWP as much as possible, but it's not working out for him at the moment. They've been having to deal with a lot of smokes from the T side, and I do wonder if it would have been worth picking up an M4 and being more dynamic on this occasion. But it is the last round of the first half, so won't matter anymore after this one. And again, Zek just gets naded into oblivion straight away, and again, it's a very early one-man advantage for Savage. And Mobility are paying for these early losses in this round. And look at they've got 2 smoke grenades to work with here. So they can't delay the pushes for that long from the T side. And again, Glorin's gonna take out Skip now. Slip, sorry.
He's poking out there towards Quad out of Boiler, and quick frag to be found. So that's going to open up the map completely. I mean, where do they put the odd amount of players that they have? Lucky going to find himself a kill from Pit, though, on the defense as they make their way up Quad. Might just find ahead of Hades, and he does. Going to take the frag down quite easily. Will Lucky, as things do square up here between the two teams. We do have Dumour making his way in now as Sidoff rests at the back of the site. Carefully awaiting now the players on the approach. Will not find a frag, as Pete now comes in with some good spray, finds the head of Relic somehow, as Dumour now enters into the one-on-two situation. Bomb will go down, but that smoke is disappearing rapidly. See if he can find himself the first quick frag. He's going to have to do that. He has any hope of winning this situation. There it is, and goes for it, but barely able to take down Lucky. Or barely not able to take down Lucky, as he is surviving just about. So there is the defuse, as we have a 7-8 half. And already we are seeing that this match is a lot closer than some of the bets would have let on.
Yeah, well, not an ideal half for mobility. Let a lot of rounds slip out of their grip that then they might have wanted here. But again, those early picks just proved to put them on the uphill struggle. And they will have to serve Savage with the same treatment here. So, let's
go. Slip is like super well mannered. Yeah, I'm a slip fan.
That's
now.
Always nice to see. So hopefully Zek will be able to get it more into this game in this second half here and help his teammates win some rounds. And we have a three-man stack here early on Banana, and the mobility team look to overwhelm the T's on the A site, but Hades will get a fast pick as we have a push here down Banana from the CTs, which we didn't see in the first half, and now the mobility team are going to be in a lot of trouble, going to have a lot of places to look to defend themselves, and they are running out of people and guns.
Looks like we're having quite a strong situation here from our CTs. There you go, it's going to be Dumour who does take the kill there.
They seized that round. Savage decided that they wanted that round, and they took it very, very quickly.
If it was only as simple as that.
Indeed. I could show you the way, DDK. If only.
What are these godlike powers you talk about?
I don't know, but you gotta pay me for them first. Then I'll show you.
I don't have any money. Oh. I can trade you, though. I can trade you shoes. Holy shoes.
We'll talk about it later. Okay, so we have a boost here on the B bomb site. Now we'll see if Valens with the big popper pump. He's got the Scott Steiner out. Let's see if he can get any frags here as the T's. Oh, that's money.
dollar bills rolling in.
Can feel his wallet expanding. He does go down though, and if the T's can get the bomb down, this is going to be really important for them. It means they're going to be able to buy in the next round. Pete does have a FAMAS, but he's also planting the bomb, which leaves him disabled for a few seconds, but he has got the bomb down. The smoke has bloomed again. So Hades is going to be here for a while. He's going to push the smoke as his teammates approach the bomb site and gets the frag on Pete as well. Takes the last man standing. Hades runs out of bullets, but Relix has got an M4.
What is going on right now, Zek? Finally. Oh my god.
Confusion, doubts.
The weird thing was that first kill that he got, that took so many bullets.
Yeah.
He should have actually had enough bullets left to kill the next guy. I think I got quite lucky there.
Yeah. The fountain was in the way, and I don't think he could see properly through the smoke. At the moment in Counter-Strike, it seems like if you're a viewer, you can see through the smoke more than an actual player can in the game, which is very weird, but there we go. So we have a... bunch of terrorists just hanging around in T-spawn at the moment. Chicken Coop is like their street corner, but they are emerging out now. We have an AK and a Galil, a Deagle, and two CZs. So we've got the mixed buy, and this is a purchase to keep the Savage economy down as low as possible, as you mentioned in the previous match in the European stream, DDK.
Yeah, definitely important. I mean, it is certainly a choice as well. Some teams decide not to put so much fought into pressure of the opponent's economy, and don't weight their decisions towards that as much as Dumour suddenly wondering what are these bullets flying from the side.
Had his bell rung.
Yeah, that was pretty dangerous there. Looks like they're going to go for some frags here, but kind of a sloppy push in, but set off with the Deagle, going to find himself some love there. Two frags already. Lovely stuff indeed from set off. Magnificent, one might say, as that Relix is going to just throw that molly in, but it's going to be a slip to take the frag, and Savage, if this was a play to damage their economy, well, I think it's a mission success already.
He's got one HP. This is completely undoable. I mean, what does he do here? This is a very difficult situation.
What he does here is dies. There you go.
Yeah, looking at the money to see... where he's going to be if he does fall. But again, this is what we're talking about. I think part of the decision-making process when you go for the mixed buy there to break the economy comes down to where both teams are in terms of rounds as well. And you can see Savage with only 10 rounds worth, with only 10 rounds on the board, it's absolutely worth Mobility making that gamble to try and break their economy, as their economy was broken when they were on the CT side. If Savage have 13 rounds, let's say, then it may be worth them ecoing that round to definitely get the full buy in the following round. But they've got the rounds to play with here, Mobility, and the gamble has paid off for them in spades.
It's one of the things that the three French teams are actually so far ahead of a lot of other teams in the European scene on right now is their understanding of when to take risks and the types of risks that they need to take. And that's like a very good point, because this is a game where you can't just play it passively, especially at the very top level, when the difference in execution is so marginal. And here we go, gonna make their way in right now through quad, smoking off Arch, as they have slowly all but eliminated where Savage can possibly be, and it's going to be a free plant. So very well done by Mobility here to arrive at a situation such as this.
Indeed, and we're going to finally see the rotation from the B bomb site by the remaining Savage players. There's no armor, no nades, all they have is P250, so looks like they're going to go and try and get as much damage in as possible, but they're going to be late to the site, and it's going to be hard for them to get any kills here, but they do need to stick together. We've got a re-rotation here from Valiant, who's going back via CT spawn, and Lucky will fall to Dumour, who will pick up that AK and definitely run for his dear life. But Sidoff has got the flank and takes it down. He's going to take care of that AK and make sure nobody picks it up late into this round. Looks like Valens may go for it, but that bomb explosion probably has pushed it down towards the bottom of mid. And in fact, it has, and Glorin's picks it up at the other end. So quite lucky in that situation. And that's something to note. If you have an AK or another gun in the middle of mid and you're trying to protect it from apps, then shoot it towards bench and maybe it won't go so far post-explosion.
All right, well, there's the quick smoke towards a deep banana. And we're going to see that actually pop off there. And Lucky's going to sprint on through, which is actually a good reaction. There's no Molotovs or flashes that came out. Does lose the challenge, but that's actually worth going for regardless. As now actually they decide to try to commit for more frags. They're making them happen against the AKs. And that is a 3-2 now. Do more in a critical position to hold. As they did see the bomb. You already see the rotation coming in there from Valens. It's like Lawrence is going to go down, and that's going to open a path for that bomb plant here for Mobility. As we do see Valens making his way slowly onto that A site. Of course, he must synchronize with his teammates, Dumont, who is approaching from quad slowly. And there are grenades here for them to use. As we do see Sidoff in a very strong position here over by the pit. Dumont making his way in slowly. So counter grenades do go into delay them just that little bit much more. And in they are now on top of the site. Valens in with the first kill. Dumour was completely executing Sidoff there in pit. And that was very well done by Savage. And they move 11-9 and certainly are in a very good position moving forwards, as they do keep those two AKs. And Mobility have now a very shaky buy.
Two fast headshots there from Savage to bring that round back into their bag. They kind of stole that round there. It was a very good retake from both players from that team. And the Mobility guys did get the bomb down. They're going to be able to get their full buy on. And again, we're going to see massive pressure on the Savage economy here. Savage with a bunch more nades, and that's a fast pick.
This round is worth two for Savage as well. If Savage win this round, they can essentially count themselves on 13. But the same goes both ways. If Mobility win this round, they're looking at pretty much tying up the game. So it's a very, very key round here. A very key round that already Mobility have taken an early advantage in.
Now, the question is, they're going to have to try and bait these CTs to exhaust their grenades as much as possible, which means they get almost free passage towards these bomb sites. We're going to have an aggressive position here from Valens, who's just going to retreat. Again, the Savage team don't know where the bomb is right now, so they're going to have to peek here and there to try and get some information so they can rotate some players in time, but it may not be enough time for Valens to get some support, as we have three Ts, make it five, all looking to breach the B bomb site. They're not even going to throw any nades. No prior warning. We've still got three players hanging around A for Savage. One does start to rotate, but could it be too late? Valens here gets the first pick, but can he get the second?
Bomb does go down on the grill, As Valens holds construction for his team, this is incredibly important for the CTs to actually make the retake possible, is to make sure that they have construction. Mobility didn't have a chance to take that away from them, so that's very strong to give them a chance. As you can see, they're already up close to the site, as their players' cavalry can make their way through pool. Already two frags found by Glorians as they make their way to the deep areas of the bomb site. In comes Siddle, so lurking from that banana area. And there it is, great triple from Lucky, and that's going to be the round there for Mobility, as we do see Savage in economic turmoil.
That is the advantage of taking a site with five people. With only one opponent there, he did manage to get one of them down, but they had lots of time to execute a post-plant setup and put themselves in the most optimal spots to stop Savage in their tracks. It is going to be 10-11 here in favor of Savage, but they are going to be on the eco, as DDK said. Valens with the grenade and flashbang, all with P250, so let's see if they can connect with some faces again. They've put an extra man towards the B-bomb site, looking to play that corner angle here, but they've also got a man in bedroom, basically just trying to get all the close quarters one-shots with those P250s, and Mobility will be very tentative in their approach. This time they're looking to fish around at the two players. Hades is going to go down to Siddhoff, and Flip will get the second kill on Glorians, and now we see the picks have made them go towards A in full force.
We need a flashbang in the studio, James. We got a grenade, an HE, we need a flashbang now. That's all I have to say about that. Well, just a laugh.
Well, thanks for the insight there. Insights and hilarity here at the FACEIT TV studios. And Valens is going to be the last man standing here. Lucky is the only one to go down for Mobility, so this is going to be an economically rich round for them. They do get their bomb down as well. And I think delirium has kicked in for Mr. DDK next to me.
Well, Valens is still looking for something, but easy round here on the anti-eco from Mobility. I mean, they challenged apartments. They did it in an effective way and limited any damage by Savage. And I still maintain that we do need a flashbang in the studio. But
it might burst our eardrums.
Well,
what if it went off by accident while we're sitting at the table?
I don't know.
Let's find out. By the way, DDK was telling us a story earlier about Pyromania, but we'll get to that during the break maybe, as we do have a charge up mid here from Pete. He's going to flashbang himself in and just go for the tags. Glorin's left on all of 5 HP, but importantly, he can jump back into the pit and get some more protection from the structures around him, and that will slow down the T-push as they have lost the man here. And we'll see if Glorin's can survive this next onslaught.
Hades in a pretty risky position, does get himself out of that, and with a frag as well from around CT Arch now. As Glorin's 5 health in pit, this is certainly very tough. But if he's been watching some Forest demos recently, I'm sure he's going to be making some ridiculous plays from that position regardless. As we do have the three men alive from Mobility slowly working their way up quad towards that A-bomb site. You have Hades now spamming away through the smoke. The bomb will go down as the kills also come in from Mobility. They square things up. In fact, they do better than that. They put it to their favor, but Relix is going to come in here with some good M4 work on top of that site. But that bomb is still ticking away, and there's still two players left to pressure from Slip and Lucky, and they will find themselves a respective one-on-one each, and that is going to be the round for them. As Mobility are 12-11, and we are certainly looking at a very distressed Savage lineup who can barely afford the clothes on their back.
That last T defusing the bomb there, face planted the bomb after dying, almost as if he was trying to eat the bomb like it was ice cream, but no, it's full of C4. So it will be one round advantage to Mobility here, as we see a four-man stack on Banana from the Savage team. They are going to push down like hungry dogs, but no one's going to be there to eat. The bomb could get caught if they push this smoke in the middle of Banana, but no, they are going to go around to quad and getting aggressive and fast here, so maybe they feel like the CTs are somewhere behind them. They have swarmed around the site. We've got Valens looking for a pick in apps, which isn't going to come straight away, and Hades playing the arch while his teammates arrive to help him.
So you won't find the kill on Zeg. That's going to allow him to pick up a weapon too. So the bomb does go down, so Mobility looking strong here. Obviously, not much to be expected from the eco, but doing a little bit of damage here, and then two players going down. The players at this point is not exactly what matters, but ooh, that could be a very nice save of an AK, unless he does want to go for it. He doesn't have a kit. This is the problem for relics right now. He can't really mess around. Has to instantly take a kill. Spraying for dear life. And it's going to be the round there for mobility. As we do get the buy coming in from Savage. And they can work in the AWP now. In fact, they will on Hades. And whether or not they decide to go for an aggressive play with Hades, you know, just down apartments or just through to balcony straight away, he's got the spawn that he can go for a quick balcony to second mid peak. And that can be very strong. Kenny S, the master of such peaks. As we do see him just waiting, flashed off of a timing there, a timing peak towards middle. The aggression started to come in here on Banana. There it is, actually, just going to hit the site really fast, actually, before the smokes even go in and pop. We do have Dumont trying to hold down the construction. They absolutely have to deal with him straight away. He's going to get two frags, holds it like a giant. Sit off and slip, barely able to do much damage to him either. Just 16 health left there. And so lucky charge through the smoke. Valiant effort here from Demo, still holding it down for his team, keeping that avenue of attack open for them, as we do have Pete and Zek working on this defense. It's going to be glorious, though, to take down Pete, which leaves things in the hands of Zek in the back of the site, and it seems like his hands were unable to just cope with that situation. We do barely have ourselves a defuse from Demo, as he stayed alive that entire round. He was there at the start of the rush, locked it down with the two frags, and then comes in at the end for the defuse. That is big stuff there from Dumont.
That was a massively important round there for Savage. It has done significant damage to the mobility economy, but also, if had they lost that, they would have been pretty much done, smoked like kippers. They are going to have an aggressive push down Banana once again, but the T's are just going Rambo style now, just rushing A, rushing B. They don't give a damn about any smokes, nades, anything. They're just going for it. They're going to wrap through Banana, CT spawn, and take out both players from the B bomb site. Only the third one remains, Hades. He is in a position where they could sandwich the T's if they play this correctly. Is he going to throw the nade and expose his position, or just go for a quick pick with the gun? He is indeed going to do the latter. Doesn't manage to get the frag, however, and it's going to be only Valens against four players here. Mobility looking to make it 14-12.
Certainly it's going to be very tough times for Savage. I mean, they definitely have the opportunity to come back. What is the money like for them right now? Let's have a look.
They're in trouble. They're in a lot of trouble.
That's looking like a very game-overy position. They have two options. They have either the option to play for overtime, or they have the option to just force it up after this. And looking at their money, like, once again, very briefly, how many rounds have they lost in a row now? That two? If it's two, it'd be $1,900 that they'll get. So, assuming that that's the case, they are going to be super screwed for money. Yeah, something around that. Maybe even just for the one round, the 1,400. But yeah, they are super screwed for money. They got the save on the M4.
They got a force.
And they're going to force it up. Okay. All right. So, what are the options like for them here? I mean, Mobility should play this incredibly passively. That's what they should do. They should account for possibilities of aggression and surprise plays, which can often trump other advantages that may be held by the opponent. We are going to see a standard straight-up play here from Savage. They are pushing apartments a little bit, so they do know what's going on, but the straight-up B push is coming in. They're not messing about right now. Mobility going in for the kill. And it was not a pretty sight to behold. And there you go, bit of a dirty kill there from Glorians in the crawl space. Pops out to pick up that AK. He's going to be able to save that, but obviously...
Well, maybe, but the hounds have been released here, and they are hunting for him like a trio of bloodhounds, basically. But they are two of them very low. That is the first frag, but he has to reload. I don't know if he can at the right time. We have people with their Karen bits out looking to get some slicing and dicing done. And it is going to be match point to Mobility. They have shown savage aggression, no pun intended, on this second half. It's been really great to see. They're just doing what's been unexpected and catching Savage unawares at times when they've got their grenades out in their hands, not expecting the ability to just YOLO through smokes, etc. They're flashing themselves in, and they've just done fantastic work, and it's been overwhelming Savage round by round. And here we go again. The Mag 7 is still alive, and Valiant's get the first place. The bomb is down. There's a second one. Can he get the third? He could get four here. If he sprays in the right place, that is the third one there, and this has gone all wrong for mobility for the time being, but it is 2-on-2 here. Sidoff only with 18 HP, Pete with 52. This is anyone's right now.
Sick play from Valance. There's number four. Can he find the ace? Sidoff is there. He's barely standing right now. He's bleeding out. Severe trauma to the head right now as Valance comes in. Slowly just waiting behind that smoke. He's so hungry for it. He's so hungry for the ace. But the stakes are quite significant. That bomb down there in the most precarious of positions as Sidoff is going to be looking for that through the smoke. That's the only place that, you know, he can really try to make things happen from. So he's just going to wait it out as I need to see this ace from Valance. And there it is. We get the ace from Valance. Lovely stuff by Valance. The mag to AK. The stop. Beautiful.
Are we going to see Valiant drop an AWP? No, he's going to go for the M4. It's probably a sensible idea here, as Savage could probably do with the additional versatility for all their players.
Games are so nice. Look at them. They're just complimenting him.
Yes,
they are so nice.
These are perfect gentlemen here in this North American League. And again, we've got three people on the B site, just in case there's a crazy bloodthirsty rush again from mobility. But they're going to play it a bit calmer now. If they do lose this round, then the economy is not going to be in a in the most pearliest of states. But they should be able to get that buy-in for the final round. But they don't want it to go to that final round. They want to take this now.
All right. Well, they are setting up for the A push at the moment. Just once again, just keeping it simple. It's been working for them so far, and the counter grenades are going to flood in here for the Savage, as Glorence is going to go down to the AK of Slip. Let's find the angle from Boiler there. So looks like they're going to go for the re-peek here, and oh, this could be dangerous. Now they have to run back to the site, can't go to pit, which would have been the best position here for Relix, but he is going to get the kill anyway, so maybe he'll find the opportunity to get better positioning, as we do see the push actually happening towards Banana. But now they're going back again, forcing a rotation. We do have Savage rotating the second player, or at least he's floating between the sites, and they're going to spot a real push coming in. Take down Sidoff. Oh, there's the second. Sec now going to be in a quick one-on-one perhaps, if unless Hades is going to wait to synchronize with his teammate, but he's going to run around the angle. And Hades, oh, he's going to actually drop. Do more. Coming in now. Slowly but surely. Sec is quite low. 34 health in the site. As D more does slowly edge his way in. He's spamming the bomb boxes. They're going to. Oh, barely seeing a pixel. Going to go for the 1-on-1. Sec does make it real. And we have ourselves a fantastic match, actually, there. Mobility managing to do a really good job there. But Savage had some sick rounds as well. They had a really nice T half.
Savage had a great first half, but Mobility just brought